Hey guys, it's Ella, aka Haroni, and I'm gonna teach you guys how to do this very easy masking transition shown on the screen. And it's pretty easy transition and does add a little bit of spice to your edit, so let's get into it.
Okay, and what you're gonna wanna do is first, when you're picking, okay, so for this transition, when you're trying to do it, you're gonna wanna try to find a scene like these ones that have some sort of opening in them. So they can either be heads touching, there just needs to be an opening somewhere. Like for this one, there's a small opening, but there has to be, like maybe there's a big opening in the middle, like just something that you can mask out where there's space between both characters. I hope that makes sense.
So as you can see, we have two clips, and the top clip is gonna last the entire duration of the transition. And I did add a marker right there that shows that the transition, that's gonna be exactly where the transition begins, like where it zooms in like into the mask. So I just marked that just for reference. But the top clip is gonna be the clip that we're going to use as our mask, and the bottom is what we're gonna want is the clip that's gonna be visible behind the mask. So the first thing you wanna do is add your Twixter like I do. I'm just adding one of my Twixter presets. And I'm gonna add my Twixter to both clips. And I can do another tutorial for that Twixter, but you're gonna wanna add it to both clips just so it's super slow, because when you mask, you really want it to be slow so there's not a lot of movement in the characters, so you don't have to mask more keyframe. So I'm just running it through just to make sure it's played back correctly. And what you're gonna do is split the bottom clip and delete the first half, so that the top clip is lasting the full duration, but the bottom clip is only starts where the top clip ends. Then we're going to pre-compose the top clip, and you have to do that, and you have to make sure the settings are the same with the attributes and stuff. And we're going to add blur mode curves. After we add blur mode curves, I'm going to assume that your transition, you're going to want to, this is going to be one of your transitions, so we want it to come out of a transition. So I'm just going to do a simple zoom out, and we'll come back when I finish that zoom out. Okay, so I finished putting in my zoom out and shake, and yeah, it just should be some transition like that, like this. And I just chose a zoom out just because I pretty much use it all the time. Okay, and then what you're going to want to do is basically we're gonna pre-compose this clip again, so make sure the settings are the same, and we're gonna go into that layer and split that in half. So we're gonna split it in half right where the transition like begins, so we want it to begin right there. So I'm gonna duplicate that actually, and once we duplicate that, you're going to want, we duplicated this so we can kind of hide, do the mask on the top layer and have a non-mask on the bottom layer, and you'll see why. So I'm just gonna pre-compose both of those so the transit, like the blur mode curves aren't on the layer, and we have a fresh new layer. And then we're gonna start masking. So you're gonna wanna mask the open space out of wherever you want it. So if it's like two people, you're gonna wanna mask the open space between those people. But for my instance, I have this little hole that I wanted the transition to go through, so I'm just gonna mask that whole entire area. And the mask doesn't have to be that clean because we're gonna edit it later, but I'm just doing a simple mask right there, sloppy mask on quarter size, on quarter quality. And yeah, and I'm gonna you're gonna want to click the eye on the bottom layer just so it's invisible, and then we're gonna invert it so that we just get so that the mask in the middle is cut out. Then you're gonna wanna feather it just so it looks a lot smoother. So you can do 30, you can do 50, what? And then you go in full, and then we're gonna wanna actually clean up the mask. So as you can see, when the full loads, it's gonna be a little bit crusty. So we're gonna wanna play with the points just to like clean it up a bit. But you're gonna wanna do this, like it doesn't really matter if you do it or not, it's kind of optional, but if you want it to look a little bit cleaner, no one's gonna really see if it's not that good, so I don't really take that much time cleaning it up and making sure the mask is perfect. So just kind of touch it up a little bit to your liking, and yeah. But we're gonna come out of this, and once your mask is done, we're gonna do some touching up later, just as, because people move, but we're gonna wanna actually disable, we're gonna enable the opacity, and we're gonna actually For the bottom clip, we're gonna wanna make it 100 and then 0 on our keyframes, just so it kind of like fades out, the bottom fades out, so it's a lot smoother, and we'll see that later. But you're just gonna wanna fade it out, the bottom, so it doesn't look that, like, it's just not a really, like, it's, it doesn't show and then disappear. We want it to disappear slowly. But as you can see, when we play back, the mask looks crusty again, so we're gonna wanna actually fix the mask by doing a mask path, as you can see I'm doing. So you're gonna wanna enable mask path, and we're gonna add keyframes. So we're gonna do mask path right there, we're gonna add a keyframe right there. And at the beginning and at the end, we're also just gonna wanna move it around to actually look better. So I'm gonna put it back on full just to see better, and just make sure to get rid of like the blue from the other, from the actual background, just like that. Once that's done, I'm going to play it back just so you guys can see. And now it's much more cleaner than it was before we touched up the mask path. So we basically got the basics done, which is the disappearing mask and cutout. So next, what we're going to want to do is, you can see the clip is behind it. So we're one step closer to finishing the transition. Now we're going to add blur mode curves to the top clip to zoom in. So what you're going to do is actually put Zetus, which is zoom in, and we're going to want to bring it to the endish, and we're going to want to zoom it in until it's gone. But first we're going to use center, and we're going to put the center right in the middle so that the zoom in, that's like the zoom in point. So once we're going to play with Zetus so it zooms in until the mask is gone, and yeah, you can see that. And now we're going to actually play with the graph, so you can just copy my graph if you're not familiar with graphs, or play with it on your own. But we want it to just like kind of go down, so we want it to be fast at the beginning, kind of slow at the end, just like that. As you can see, the transition is pretty good so far, but to make it even better, we're gonna actually want to zoom it in a little bit, like on the bottom clip. So like, we can, like, I played with the keyframes again a little bit, but it's pretty good. We just want to actually pre-compose the bottom clip and do a zoom transition on that one too with blur mode curves. So we're gonna add a Zetus keyframe at the beginning and the end to match up the keyframes on the top, and we're actually gonna want to first keyframe pretty high, because the higher make your number, the more zoomed out it is. But we're gonna copy the same center values as the one on the top. So I'm just gonna go back and forth just to copy the center values. And we're going to, once it's the exact same center, we're gonna raise the Zetus a lot so it's very zoomed out, so it actually moves with the transition. So you can always edit it later like I will, but I'm just gonna bring it up to 2. And we're gonna do another graph, and it's gonna kind of match the graph on the first one, but you want it to be a little bit slower, like you'll see. Like, we want it to transition to actually just move a little bit differently, but I just needed to wrap my stuff first. So we're gonna just do a simple zoom in transition like this, and we're gonna play it back and see. And if you like it, you can, that's basically it, but you can also play with it a little bit. And I didn't really like how it looked, so I'm gonna actually make the value a little bit smaller. So I'm just gonna do 2.6, so it's really zoomed out, and I'm just gonna play with the keyframe, the graphs, a little bit more, just so it looks better. And as you can see, it looks a little bit better than it did before. So that's basically it, but this is an optional part that you can do. Now if you want to, you can pre-compose both clips together. This is what I do when I do this transition. I pre-compose both clips together, and we're gonna wanna actually play with opacity so that it fades out a little bit before the transition, and then as soon as the transition starts, we want it to be bright. So it just like jazzes it up a little bit. So the next one, we're gonna just add brightness and contrast, and I'm just gonna do it with you guys. So we just add brightness and contrast, enable brightness, press U on your keyboard, and then make a brightness keyframe there and towards the end. And the first one we're just gonna play with, you can do whatever value you want, but I'm just gonna do 150, just so it's pretty bright, and then it's just gonna like fade out, so we don't really need to play with the graphs. So as you can see, that's basically all you need to do. You can add text, you can add anything.
Okay, thank you guys for watching. I don't really know what to call this transition. I'm just gonna call it like a mask opening. Like, I don't know really what to call it, but that's a transition that I use pretty much in every edit. It's pretty simple now, but it's really simple to do, but it does add some spice to your edit. So if you want to do it, go ahead and try it. Tag me in your edits. I really want to see them. And I really hope this helped you guys. I'm pretty bad at explaining, so basically just watch the video and watch what I do. I'm never really explain well in general, so make sure to subscribe, like this video, comment if it helped, and comment any other transitions you guys would like me to do. Thank you.